Alright, using True Space 5, I'm going to show you guys how to make a rook chess piece. First, you're going to come over here and you're going to grab a cylinder. And you can make it wherever, it doesn't matter what size you make it, because you're going to fix it. You're going to right click on the white arrow. Make sure that everything on the X and Y axis is zero, so it's right in the middle of your screen. Makes things a lot easier to work. And then your size, we can just put 6. I mean, you can pick whatever size you want. Just remember that the bottom of it is smaller. Then what you're going to do is you're going to grab over another cylinder. And once again, it doesn't matter what size. Make sure everything's centered so it's right on top. And then we'll make a 10. And how thick you want it. Since the top one's usually thicker, 4 is too big. 2.3, I think, sounds good. And then you can just left click on that white arrow and pull it up so it's right on top. If you want, type in over here like 1.7 so you know that it's not over it, but it's right on top. And then what you're going to do is you're going to take a sphere, and then you're going to do the same thing as you did. Make sure everything's right in the middle. And then you're going to make that maybe like 7. And then you're going to come over here, and we'll make it maybe 2. Maybe that's a little too small. We need it to be a little round. But the bottom of it's kind of small. And then what you can do is you're going to come over here and you're going to lift it up. You can see it. It's how deep you want it. Make sure it doesn't go down to the bottom, though. I'm going to put mine like right here. Make sure everything's still centered in the middle. And then what you're going to do is you're going to click on this, your middle piece. Click on the subtraction tool. And then there you go, you got your circle. And then if you look over here, you're almost done. You got the top of it. And then what you have to do is you just have to make a drill. It still doesn't matter what size you make it. Just make sure everything's centered. And then you're going to come over here. Depends how big you want your drill. Make mine 1. Make sure the Y is like 10 or maybe a little bit bigger. Maybe like 12 so you can see it coming out on both sides. And then with this one, your last column doesn't really matter because if you just look up here, you can see how deep your rivet's going to be, like right up here. You can see how deep you want it. Alright, make sure everything's still centered though. Alright, and I'll make mine a little bit deeper. I think right there is good. And then what you're going to do is you're going to you're going to click on your middle tool again. And you're going to, keep it at 0. And then you're going to right click on your subtraction tool. Keep the drill. You don't want these two marked, the delete edges in the first one. You don't want those marked. And then you're going to click on this one. And you're just going to delete your top drill. And then you can come down here. Oh, and then you're going to click this. And you're going to come down here and type in 90. And as you can see, you've already got your first cut. And then you're going to do the same thing. You're going to click. And click on your middle part. Click the subtraction tool. Click the top. And then you can click this. And you can delete it. And there you go. Then you got your rook.